Hi beautiful, welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be on products I wish I had tried before. These are products that finally came into my life and made it into my collection in 2020, but they were released in previous years and I just never bought them. And now I'm like, what was I thinking? I should have had this a long time ago because they are lovely, beautiful products that I am obsessed with, and I just cannot wait to share them with you guys. So if you are excited for this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up before you leave. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're new here. And with that said, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so first things first, we are going to talk about refer brushes because these did not launch this year, but they came into my life this year and they have totally changed the way that I do my makeup. They revolutionized the blending process for me. I could blend before having refer brushes. I could blend with Morphe and Sigma and other brushes, but these just make it easy. If you have any Japanese natural hair brushes, you know that they are so soft and so movable that whenever you apply any product to your face, it blends out a lot faster than with other brushes. And in some cases also, like Morphe brushes to me feel a little bit stiff and like pinchy, like they kind of, if I blend a lot, I kind of feel it on my crease. And these are just so gentle on your skin because the hairs are so freaking soft. So I think this is my whole refer brush collection right here. As you can see, every single brush is dirty because I use these on a daily basis. They are still having a really good sale on the refer website, and I believe that once they run out of brushes, they're not going to restock till like February because it takes time to produce these brushes, of course. And so my starter kit with refer was the core collection, and I think that is a great way to get yourself introduced to the line. The core collection is still on sale for $88, which is $80 less than what it usually retails for, so this is an amazing deal still. And I'm going to tell you my absolute favorite refer brushes that I cannot live without. Some of them come in the core collection. So from the core collection, the only brush that I don't use on a daily basis is the number 4 brush, and that's because I don't contour on a daily basis, but I use brushes 1, 2, 3, and 5 daily. Besides those though, I have other recommendations of brushes from refer that I absolutely love, and those are these right here. So from the holiday collection, I have brushes 24 and 23 that I use almost daily. Brush 24 is my favorite one for when I want to apply bronzer in a specific space. Like, I don't want it to be all over. I want it to kind of define my cheek a little bit. This is what's going to do that for me. And then the brush 23 is a teeny, teeny, tiny detail brush for the eyes, and I use this one to like smoke out my eyeliner, smoke out the eyeliner underneath the eye. It does a tremendous job at those little tasks. The other brush that came in the holiday collection, which I do use a lot, is brush number 25. And this one I use for my bronzer when I want my bronzer to look just airbrushed and I don't care for a lot of precision, because as you can see, it's a pretty big brush. But this one also people love for all over face powder. I just personally don't put face powder all over my face every day. One more face brush I've fallen in love with is brush number 18. This one I just recently got, and it's the perfect size to apply powder to your under eye area. And then the other three eye brushes I use daily are going to be brushes 13, 14, and 15. 13 is my favorite one to blend out my eyeshadow underneath the eye. 14 I use sometimes for that, but also for like the outer V color on my eye. This one is fantastic to just add a little bit of depth to your outer corner and blend it into your crease with such ease. And then brush number 15 is my favorite one to just blend out the colors on my crease very seamlessly. So refer brushes totally changed the game for me. I think what makes refer very special too is that they are giving you these brushes at really good prices for what they are, because Japanese handmade natural goat hair brushes are incredibly expensive, and I know that these are pricey as well, but like in comparison, these are a really good deal. So these are definitely the first and most important thing that came into my life in 2020 and changed the game for me. I did not know what I was missing out on. The second product I finally tried in 2020 that I don't know why I didn't have before is the Sultry palette. Right at the beginning of quarantine, I uploaded my video ranking the Anastasia palettes, and I have pretty much every Anastasia palette except for the Sultry palette and the Mario palette. And half of the comments on that video were just yelling at me because I did not have the Sultry palette, and a subscriber was kind enough to send it to me. I ended up creating content around it. I did a 5 looks, 1 palette video with it, which you guys seem to really like. And this is really one of the best Anastasia palettes. I think if I were to like rank it now, it would probably be top 6, top 7. I'm not sure. I haven't actually thought about the spot that I would put it in, but it is up there. It's not going to be among the top 3 or 4, I don't think, just because I personally don't gravitate towards cool tones as much. But if you like cool tones and you haven't tried this palette yet, now it's the time to get it. When I made that video and uploaded it, this was discontinued, but Anastasia just brought it back for the holidays in some sort of a kit. So if you guys are interested in getting this one, I definitely recommend that you get that kit, because it also has like mascara and eyeliner and a bunch of other nice things from Anastasia. So if you don't know, this is what the Sultry palette looks like right here. It is absolutely beautiful and a great palette to use on a daily basis. So this is definitely a palette that came out before 2020 and it made it into my life this year. So thank you guys so much for telling me that I needed it, because I really like it. It's a really wonderful palette. Another older palette, none of these are old products, they are just not 2020 products, but another older palette that came into my life this year, actually super extremely recently, is the gold palette from Natasha Denona. This palette I've had my eye on forever. I have wanted this gold palette since it came out, since I can remember, but this was just extremely out of my budget before. I couldn't see myself spending $129 on this eyeshadow palette when it first came out. Turns out, if you saw my rankings video from Natasha Denona, this is my favorite Natasha Denona palette now. It's, I think, worth it because it made it all the way to number 1 in my collection from all of the Natasha Denona palettes that I own. I definitely still prefer her 65 midi size eyeshadow palettes. I think those are spot on. However, this one does not come in that size and I have wanted it forever, and so I finally have it. It is my favorite Natasha Denona palette and I love it. I'm glad I was able to get it now. I actually picked it up during the Sephora VIB sale. I'm going to get back to makeup in a second, but something else that I've known about forever that just made its way into my life this year was Jo Malone fragrances. I have had Jo Malone in the past, but what I've had from Jo Malone in the past was candles. To me, before I worked at Nordstrom, Jo Malone just made fabulous smelling candles. And then when I worked at Nordstrom and seeing all of the products that they have in store there, I immediately was drawn to the line. And I recently finally purchased a product from Jo Malone, and it was this one right here. This is their 2020 limited edition holiday scent. It's called Midnight Musk and Amber. I've recommended it to you on Instagram and I think in one other video before, and I really love this perfume. It is sexy and nice and intense. If any of you like musky perfumes, I think you would really love this one. It has juniper, amber, and 3 types of musks in it, if I'm not mistaken, and it is just a fabulous smelling perfume. Besides that, I also have the mimosa and cardamom perfume from Jo Malone, and this one was actually given to me by Nikki, who works for Jo Malone, and I am obsessed with this one. She asked me what my favorite scent from Jo Malone was, and I said, well, besides the Midnight Musk and Amber, which I had already bought, I love Mimosa and Cardamom, and this is one of their like signature scents that is always there. And she got it engraved for me, which is so freaking cool, so let me show you the engraving. I lowered the light so you guys can see it. It says Patty Alonso right there at the bottom, just like my YouTube channel. And this engraving is a personalized thing that we can sometimes do at Nordstrom. We're actually going to have another engraving event very soon, and it's not just for Jo Malone, it's for any fragrances that Nordstrom sells. So if you guys want to have anything engraved for a loved one for the holidays, message me on Instagram and I can place the order for you and have it engraved soon. I forgot the date, but it's very soon. I think it might be this weekend. And I can have it engraved for your family member. The engraving is complimentary with any fragrance purchase. But anyways, Jo Malone fragrances was definitely something that I fell in love with in 2020 that has been around for a very long time, and it finally made it into my life, into my collection, and I absolutely love it. Back to the makeup, we're about to get into some Pat McGrath products. I feel like this was my year to fully discover Pat McGrath as a makeup line and dive in head on and just buy a bunch of things from her line that I have absolutely fallen in love with and I am totally obsessed with. If you guys don't have any Pat McGrath palettes yet, here's your warning. You're not going to just get one. You're going to start with one and then you're going to fall in love and you're going to want more, because that is absolutely what happened to me. I guess let's start with some palettes. So this was the first palette I ever bought from Pat McGrath. This is the Mothership number 5 Bronze Seduction palette. And after watching other people's rankings videos, I decided that this was going to be the best one for me to start with, because it was very highly ranked in a lot of different YouTube channels. And this was an absolutely amazing Pat McGrath palette to start my collection with. Even though my Pat McGrath palette collection is not huge, I think I'm going to do a rankings video of my own very soon, so stay tuned for that. And I'm pretty sure this one is going to be very highly ranked on that video, because this palette is absolutely beautiful. It's my cup of tea. It introduced me to her Blitz Astro formulas and just the whole luxury experience that are her Mothership palette. These are pricey. They are $125 for the 10 shades. They come in very luxurious packaging, very heavy, beautiful packaging that you can have displayed at your vanity, and they are really good quality eyeshadows. So Mothership number 5 is an older palette that definitely made its way into my life in 2020, and I absolutely love it. The second Pat McGrath palette from previous years I bought was this one. This one came out, I believe, at the end of 2019, and I bought it during the spring of 2020. I have the limited edition pink packaging because I bought it with the Mothership number 8. This one is the Mothership number 7 palette. And again, whenever I do my rankings video, this one is going to be super highly ranked, because this palette is absolute perfection. I love it so much. It looks more boring than the Mothership number 5 that I just showed you, but if you are into nudie pinky shades, this is definitely the Pat McGrath palette that you need. The Blitz Astral shades in this palette are so freaking glorious. I've done 5 looks 1 palettes with both the Mothership number 5 and also with the Mothership number 7. So if you guys have them and you're looking for inspiration on those, definitely check my 5 looks 1 palettes out. And I really enjoyed the 5 looks 1 palette I made with this one. Lastly, in one of her last sales, I got my hands on the Subliminal palette, which is the first ever Mothership palette she ever released. Again, I went back and visited other people's rankings videos to see how they rank their palettes in their collection. That's kind of like how I have decided what palettes to go with. I think ranking videos are super helpful because, you know, we can't all try every single palette to then determine which one's best. So I watch a lot of people's rankings videos, and so that this was another very highly rated palette, and also the colors attracted me personally. So I recently bought it and I do not regret it one bit. I am super obsessed with this palette. I love the Blitz Astral shades in this one, and I love that this one has 3 matte shades. It has a really nice transition color. This is the only Mothership palette I haven't done a 5 looks 1 palette with yet. I am planning on it, but I'll get to it when I can. But the Subliminal, which is the Mothership number 1 palette, if you're into cool tone shades and into like blues and iridescent colors is the Mothership palette for you. Also, I keep all of my Pat McGrath Mothership palettes in its original boxes because these boxes are so beautiful to look at and also a very distinctive way to tell which palette is which. I have those like right up there and you guys can't see them. I'm thinking of changing this background soon and maybe I'll display this because I love them. Another Pat McGrath product I hadn't fully dived in previous years and I've fallen in love with their formula is the Pat McGrath lip liners. I definitely want to get more of them. I ordered Buff, which is a really nice nude one, but it got canceled, so I never got it. But I have two lip liners from Pat McGrath so far, and I really love the Pat McGrath lip liner formula. I think Pat McGrath and Charlotte Tilbury have the best lip liners. Oh, and Patrick Ta. I love Patrick Ta's lip liners as well. Anyways, the colors I have are Done Undone, which is a beautiful nudie pink shade, and also the Structure lip liner from Pat McGrath. Right now, I'm a little bit shopped out, but whenever she has maybe her spring sale or anything like that, I will definitely be picking up more of the lip liners from Pat McGrath because chef's kiss, these formulas are incredible, and I have liked both of the colors I have tried so far, and the swatches look really pretty, so I'm pretty sure that I would like a lot of her other lip liner colors as well. And then last but not least, another product that's been around for a while that I just got my hands on are the Pat McGrath lip glosses. Again, I'm a little shopped out at the moment, but I did get my hands on the Prima Donna lip gloss from Pat McGrath, which helped me try out her formula. And the formula of these lip glosses is incredible. I don't like sticky lip glosses and these are not sticky at all, so I think right now they are still on sale for $12. If you haven't picked any up, I absolutely love this pinky nude shade, and they have a lot of other really beautiful nudie colors that are very attractive to me. So check out their lip sale because they have their lipsticks, their glosses, a bunch of things at only $12, which is a fraction of their retail price for this. So of course I'm going to leave you links of everything I talked about in this video below. It definitely helps me out if you guys shop through my links. I was not able to get a lot of these things in previous years because I couldn't afford them. I was kind of managing my YouTube budget on products that were a little bit less expensive so that I can make more videos for you. And the reason I have been able to get my hands on these products now is that you guys are so supportive in shopping through my links, so I definitely have you to thank you for helping me grow my collection so that I can in turn review products for you and tell you guys what's good. Anyways, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I definitely wanted to talk about these products before the year ended and I did not know how. So thank you to everybody who also left suggestions on different titles for this video on my previous video. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for all of the support that you give me. Thank you for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you haven't already. Also, subscribe to my channel if you're new here. And yeah, that's all. I hope to see you guys back in the next one. Bye!